Hello friends, now we'll discuss an example on Simpsons one-third rule. The example goes like this. Find the approximate value of integration of root cos theta with respect to theta from 0 to pi by 2 by Simpsons one-third rule by dividing the interval between 0 to pi by 2 into six equal parts means first we need to understand what it is. Here the close interval a from 0 to b is equal to pi by 2, it is given. Then the things between 0 to pi by 2 will be divided into six equal parts, means 1 2 3 4 5 and 6, six interval part. We need to understand what will be h. Here again we say a is equal to 0 and b is equal to pi by 2. We need to calculate what is h. N also will take. What is n? N will be 6 here, because we are going to take 6 equal parts. Okay, so n is equal to 6. Okay, then we need to take the calculation of h. H will be b minus a divided by n. Therefore, h is equal to b is pi by 2 minus a is 0 divided by 6. So this becomes pi by 12. But since this is a trigonometric example, so we'll try to keep it in degree. So pi by 2 is nothing but 15 degree. So this is h. Therefore, from here to here, so this is nothing but 90 degree now. Okay. Therefore, from here to here, we'll take 0 to 90 degree with the phase of 15 degrees we will take. So it is 15 degree, 30 degree, 45 degree, 60 degree, 75 degree and 90 degree. Okay. Then we need to know what is y here. Since I is equal to integration of y dx between a to b, which is given here as integration of root cos theta with respect to theta between 0 to pi by 2, means in place of y we have root cos theta. So this is y. Okay, so let us take the values of theta as in terms of degree. So that is, the initially it starts with 0 degree, then 15 degree, 30 degree, 45 degree, 60 degree, 75 degree, then 90 degree. And we know this is x naught, this is x1, x2, x3, x4, x5 and this is x6. Similarly, we take the value of y. So y0, y1, y2, y3, y4, y5 and y6. If you use calci and if you calculate, so in calci what to do, you keep the mode as degree only, since we are taking the things for calculation for degree. Then you take y is equal to root of cos theta. So we can see here, so first what we do, we'll take here a square root of cos, then we need to calculate 0, so this is equal to 1. Therefore, y naught is equal to 1. Similarly, root cos, second is 15, then press it, then it is 0.9828. So it is 0.9828. Next we'll take root cos 30. Root cos 30 that is equal to 0.9306. So that is 0.9306. Then we take root cos 45. That is equal to 0.8408. Similarly, we calculate other values also. The other value is 0.7071. For 75, it will be 0.5087. Then for 90 degree, we know that cos 90 is 0. Okay. Then we'll take Simpson's 1/3 rule. Then by Simpson's 1/3 rule, what Simpson's 1/3 rule says? I is equal to integration of root cos theta with respect to theta between 0 to pi by 2, which will be equal to what Simpson's rule says? H divided by 3 into y naught plus yn. Yn is y6 here, plus 4 times odd values of y, y1 plus y3 plus y5 plus 2 times even value of y, y2 plus y4. y6 cannot be taken because y6 is already involved. Then you can see y0, y1, y2, y3, y4, y5 and y6. All the values of y are included and none of the value got repeated. That is the assurance here. Therefore, next we take I is equal to h. The value of h is how much? It is 15 degree. But what do I do? I'll take for the calculation, I take it as pi by 12 divided by 3. That into the value of y0, that is 1, plus y6 is 0, plus 4 times y1. y1 is 0.9828, plus y3. y3 is 0.8408. plus y5 is 0.5087, plus 2 times the value of y2 is 0.9306, plus y4 is 0.7071. Okay, so this is the value. Then we calculate I is equal to, if you take this calculation part, then it becomes pi by 36. Pi by 36 is equal to how much it will be? That we will calculate afterwards. Then we can see 1 plus, if you calculate this overall by using KLC, it becomes 9.3296, plus if you calculate this overall, then it becomes 3.2754. Okay, so this is equal to pi by 36. What is pi by 36 now? If you calculate it in a CalC, how do you calculate? You can see here pi is somewhere here. Therefore, it is a yellow color, so shift is required. So shift, then press pi button, then we get pi divided by 36. Then this is equal to 0.08726. So it is 0.087266, means I'll take it as 7, that into this bracket value is something 13.605. Okay, so overall calculation E will be, I is equal to, if you calculate this, this becomes 1.1873. So this is the value of the integral, definite integral, that is integration of cos theta d theta between 0 to pi by 2. So this is the calculation part you can see here. So this we have taken, we got A and B as well as we calculated H. Then after that we considered what is Y, we prepared the table. Then after preparing a table, we took the formula. In the formula we substituted all the values and I told you how to take the conversions and all. Then after that we got the value, that is 1.1873. Thank you.